Say hopefully. I
think this actually benefits PR quite a bit. Even though their support duo isn't really the strongest in their safe lane, this Axe is going to get absolute free farm.
On top, they're opening onto EGM. There is a roll in. Metamorphosis already. EGM gets healed, but it's not quite enough. Goddamn, though, taking heavy damage. They need a few more auto attacks with Big Num getting in the way. Aki trying to wrap around here. Also just working in onto Big Num. Can they do it? Big Num has a roll up in 1 second. Aki, you're not in front of him. Oh, goodness gracious. This is not... Oh, never mind. I spoke too soon. Big Num realizing he couldn't really roll because he might get caught.
Yeah, nice play there, though, from PR. They know that their supports are kind of weak, so right away they get the... They're on the side in position with the ward as well. They get the quick jump on EGM, and that's a kill that they can take.
Just because of the nature of both what Axe and how well the lane is going for Batrider, who do you think is going to be more effective for the that kind of first rotation?
Top lane, dude. Action going on. Okay,
Shallow Grave comes out, and with the spin onto Goddamn, they're going to get the kill. And that was through Metamorphosis. Big Num trying to throw a rock on through Arcane. Nice dodge there. Batrider's up here. Gets a kill onto Big Num. Looking for J4 as well. But that will go to Juggernaut, and the Sunstrike going to be off the mark.
Pretty close, though. But yeah, this lane setup is actually working very well for them in the top lane. However, Axe is full free farming. That's kind of the trade-off that they're doing. And it looks like the Axe is actually going to opt to go for that Vanguard first. Huh. The tri-lane, it's a full-out tri-lane. They're sticking the supports up there constantly. So Loda, almost level 5. EGM, level 4. And Bulldog picks up the Midas to accelerate his farm. 5 minutes. 5:39.
Okay. Aki, he is in a little bit of trouble. Gets dunked there, so first dunk of the game. They didn't have a question on that, did they, for the compendium? Well, roll onto Loda, but of course he is spinning. Will he be able to get out here? The magic missile is at the ready. They drop it onto the Rubik, so changing target some, but with the healing ward, oh, immediately killed up there, but goddamn, taking a lot of damage, both from the Fade Bolt, the Loda, and the Telekinesis will be enough, and it stuns two of them. J4 getting low here. One more auto attack. Loda, okay, but the auto attack from Rubik coming through.
And this is a tri-lane versus a dual lane right there, and they got absolutely decimated again. So this laning phase is coming out to be extremely beneficial now for Alliance. I didn't think that it would work out that well, but yeah, it's actually just crushing. They need a port down there though, maybe even two ports.
Oh, he just opens with the Battle Hunger. Not. I agree with you. Oh no, Cheshire Cat. There's going to be Sticky Napalm coming out. They go with the Lasso. That is the Blink reveal. Admiral Bulldog and the spin on top of Cheshire Cat. It is not looking good. He actually got some counter helixes off and did a good amount of damage because of how long the Vanguard made him take to die, but not enough.
Nice. They actually did group up and go for a push. Usually when I say something, it's completely wrong and people do the exact opposite, especially at this at the 10-minute mark. But no, they play around 3-4 spirits up, or 4-4 spirits up.
Yeah, EGM making all the units. Here we go, another smoke coming out from Alliance. They want to grab someone, get Loda another kill. They try, oh, the Daya tries for a scan because they want to know if Loda has backup. There is the Cole, the Sunstrike as well, and Loda will be blown up.
First blink usage.
Alliance unable to get anything out of this smoke.
Yeah, Loda playing maybe a little bit too far up because his buddies were already coming in as well to help him out.
At least it's a cute bear bringing down your tower, you know?
It's a panda.
Nothing like a panda destroying homes. Okay, Cheshire Cat immediately telekinesis. Didn't really hit what he wanted there. He's in a bit of trouble. Goddamn, actually doing good damage out onto Loda, but there is the pullback. Even with the Yules, Cheshire Cat still ends up going down. Meatball and the Deafening Claws, but the Omni Slash taking out Earth Spirit on the back of the fight. S4, despite being magged up, will probably survive out here. And goddamn, Paul. Rax, melee going down. They can also just go bottom on Alliance, although the cooldowns are short due to the low level, or death timer for sure.
Where did Arise use his spells on?
He used a Meatball and Deafening Blast to attempt to go on the Batrider as he came down from the Yules.
I didn't catch on the slap. Yeah, okay.
Well,
I thought they actually might have a little bit more life in them because they were starting to creep up, but no, they actually can't even contest versus Alliance's hyper push at this point.
Yeah. Well, guys, a bit of a straightforward game that we had here. I believe we have one more off.